So when you say that God manifested in the womb of a woman into a human form, and then that was God inside the womb. So God was physically a baby in the womb of a mother, and then God, the creator of the universe, who's still all together, physically came out of the womb of a mother. To me, again, that, and I don't know if anybody else finds that troubling, but
what's the troubling part? What's the argument?
All of it. It's not an argument. Again,
I know what I'm saying.
Okay. Can I ask one question for clarification? And this is just, I just want to know what you're saying. Are you saying that God can't do that, or he just wouldn't do that?
Excellent.
Because there's a difference. There's things I can't do and things I just wouldn't do.
Agreed. So, when we talk about God, and you guys have debated with atheists, so you already know that whole God can't lift a rock thing, right? That there are certain things that are against the nature of the greatness of God as it is, right? From that God, if you can say, can God make a rock he can't lift? Well, it's not only a question that you ask, because from the nature of God is greatness, right? That he's able to do all things.
So just to give the simple version, when he asked, can he do it or would he do it? Which one of those were you addressing there?
So
to me, it sounded like you, in some sense, were addressing both. But I think the fundamental claim is that he can't do it. It's against his nature.
Yeah, and,
thank you.
And for,
is that right?
As an example, like if you were to ask me, can God ride a bicycle?
Right.
I would say, well, I don't think he would, but he could if he wanted to. For some reason, God could take on a form and ride a bicycle. If you're talking about, you know, the Quran and Allah speaking on the fire, I don't know what you believe there. I believe God could do that.
I do too.
So there's that distinction.
Sure.
I believe God can enter into his creation in the form of a human being, or God's more along the lines of, well, I have the power to do that, but there's no way I would do that. It's beneath me or something like that.
So let me just give you an example, right? And I think it'll clarify this, right? Do you believe God would have sexual intercourse with a woman?
I believe God has the power to do that if he wanted to, but he wouldn't want to because of his moral nature.
Thank you. So would God do that? Get wife and have sex with her?
Yeah, but again, it's not a question of power or ability. It's a question of he wouldn't.
It's against his nature, right?
Yeah. So is that what you're saying?
Hold on. I'm asking you, if somebody was to ask you, can God get married and have sex with a woman?
I would clarify, as far as power, God has the ability to do anything that doesn't entail a contradiction or a couple of qualifications like that. As far as things that he would actually do, he's not going to contradict his own moral nature.
Thank you. So I would say again, God would not contradict his own nature by being born out of the vagina of a woman. That is the point, that God doesn't have those weaknesses that humans have. Those are against the nature of God. To have to use the bathroom, to have to sleep because he's tired, to have to worry about making the right judgment because he hasn't had enough nutrition. Those things, to me, those things and God's perfect nature cannot mix, just as we would say, that at least David said, that it would be against the nature of God to get married and have sex, and you said it would be, so I don't know, you guys can work that out at home. So in your presentation that I asked you for, and I appreciate the presentation, that God physically, not, you know, by seeing or sight, was in the womb of a woman, came out of vaginas, that's against the nature of God in what I see. Okay, that again, that's my personal belief. So you are saying that God could and
did
have sex with a woman?
If Jesus wanted to get married, absolutely. Do you think it's contrary to the nature of God for people to have these? So let me put it this way.
You're saying God did have sex with a woman?
No.
So when I was saying you jumped out, right?
No, that's not all I said.
So
he said yes before you finished.
So you said.
Come on, even it out. Come on.
So you see why you should let me finish before you say yes?
Right, David?
Yeah. Right, David?
No.
See, it's too late. You're Muslim now. Right?
No. Should we do the Shahada now or later? I was saying, do you think God could have sex with a woman? And you said he did.
Yeah,
what? What, Anthony? That's true.
No, you're right.
There you go.
Don't you have that
Shahada finger.